Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Drawing with Woodsy. It's been a year since we started this. A year ago, we drew Mickey Mouse, and is it 49 drawings later or something like that? We took a break, so now we are back to it, and we're drawing Daisy Duck. So you know how we start. We usually clean our hands. I said before that, you know, these drawings, these pencils have been in the drawer forever, and they need to be cleaned. And so do our hands. So I'm just going to clean off my hands before we start drawing. A ritual. All right, now, like normal, we're just going to start with some circles. Let's warm up. It's been a year, so. Just going to take my pencil and draw some circles up here in the corner. If you've drawn with me before, you know that these circles are just to help warm up the arm and get us prepared to draw. It also helps make the drawing sheet that we're working on look worse already, so that way we're not pressured to do a perfect drawing, because we're not going to. We're just going to try to do our best and learn from it. So I think some people look at drawing and think, I need to know exactly how to do it before I can show anyone that I did it. And that is, that's not a good way to learn. So we're gonna make some mistakes here at the start. And you can see that I'm moving my whole arm when I do the circle, so it's not just one little move with my wrist. You can do really small circles that way, but you get better freedom and flow. And since we're drawing Daisy Duck today, she has a lot of really long lines in her bow especially, so I wanna make sure that we're warmed up. And we're allowed to draw really loose like this because we're gonna go back later with a darker pencil. And once we do that, we can just sort of decide which lines we want to keep, darken those in, and then all these other scratchy lines are going to fade away. So those of you who've drawn with me before, you know that's the way we do it. And if you've drawn professionally before, you know that's the way that most people do it. So even once we start shading things in, then it makes it even more invisible, all of our little scratchy red lines. So we're gonna start with Daisy Duck's circle head, the main thing that we normally start with. And I have this ping pong ball to help show how we're gonna draw our character. So you can see I put these lines on it horizontally and vertically, and that lets us know which way the character is facing. For Daisy, we're just gonna have her look right at the camera. So we're gonna draw straight up and down, straight across. First, we gotta draw our circle. And like I said, she's got a very tall bow, so I want to leave room for it. So I'm going to draw my circle actually near the bottom of the page, right about that big. Hopefully, let's find out. I'm drawing really lightly at first, and then just kind of building on it. You see my circle's kind of squashed over here. Try to round that out more. Kind of find the circle as you go. And I find that's true for the way that I draw. I usually find the drawing as I do it, so I rarely know what it's gonna look like until it's done. So there are certain goals I might be going for, but you know, you never know how it's gonna look. Even when they get paid to do it. Okay, so like I said, she's gonna be looking right at us. So right in the middle of the circle, I'm just gonna draw a straight up and down line. A couple of them, somewhere there. And then across the bottom, not at the middle, but if you think of where the middle of the circle is and where the bottom of the circle is, just go about halfway down. You can see it's looking pretty similar to when we drew Mickey or Donald. It's classic Mondays, and Daisy, we never got to draw her, so I wanted to make sure that we have some Daisy love out there. I know there's a lot of Daisy fans. Okay, so that's our circle. If you want for yourself, just to track this, keep a mental note of how scratchy this looks, because once we finish it, remember how scratchy it was and see if it still feels scratchy. Okay, so first things first, I want to draw her eyes. And her eyes, we can draw, if you wanted, you could draw them straight up and down, like a long oval. I want to go a little bit at an angle because she has a lot of roundness to her face, and I want to sort of infer that by tilting our oval this way. So if you've drawn the circles over here, this is just a good place to practice an oval. This is a circle. An oval is a circle that's been squished, and so these little pieces come in or out. So this is more of what an oval looks like. So let's try to Do a couple of those over here. It's a great place to practice your lines. So I'm going to start about here. And the bottom of the oval is going to live right on the horizontal line that we drew. Cool. That's one eye. Now that I have the distance between this line and the center line, I want to try to mimic that over here. So basically just trying to draw this same oval over on this side. And the bottom again is on the horizontal line. Some music up. Okay, let's draw. Now that we have the top of the eyes, we're going to draw the eyebrow. One of the cool things about these classic designs, like Daisy or like Mickey or Donald, is that a lot of the things that you draw kind of flow from one to another. So once you draw the eyes, you're like, oh, okay, so now I know how the eyebrow should look. I should draw that. And it's kind of, it's an upside down U that follows the same path as the top of the eye that we drew here. So I drew that over here. I want to try to draw the same thing on this side. Dramatic music for this. Okay, now we have what looks like a little alien. We gotta give her the beak. So in order to do that, I'm going to connect the bottom of these eyes with like an upside down letter U or the letter N, the highest point right at the middle of the line here, the little vertical line that we gave. So there's a few things for her that's similar to Donald and a few things that are specifically different. So her bill is a little bit smaller than Donald's, not as wide as his. So we're going to work on that together. I'm going to draw what looks like a little candy cane that comes out to this side here and curves around. And this is sort of like the mouth corner, the little side of the beak, the bill. Candy cane. Sticks just outside of the circle, only barely. Same thing on the other side. I stuck that one too far out. Let's go closer. So, a lot of the people who draw with me have gone through this experience. You might be going through it right now, which is thinking, mine looks nothing like that. I quit. Don't do it. Don't quit. I promise you, if you get to the end of the drawing, it might not look exactly like the way that you think, but I promise you it's going to look better than you thought it would. Because the way that we draw here, we're just drawing slow, we're drawing methodically, we're thinking about it, and at the end of this drawing, we should be a little bit smarter about it than when we started. And it feels good to learn stuff, so it shouldn't be intimidating. She's got a really fun, forgiving design, so I promise you're going to like it. So let's go ahead and do the beak. Before we draw, usually I would draw the sides of the mouth here, but I actually just want to know where we're going to put the beak. So about halfway down between the horizontal line and the bottom of the sphere, keep calling it a beak, it's a bill, it's a duck bill. We're going to draw kind of a rounded, it's almost flat, but it's rounded here. And it sticks out towards the end of the circle. Just enjoy that music. Jerry Goldsmith. Okay, so now we're going to, I'm going to draw the little, if you think of the upper lip here, this is the outside of her bill. We're just going to give a little bump here, just to show that it has some thickness. And actually this line that we give here is good because it lets us know how thick our beak is out to the side. So I'm just gonna draw kind of a backwards letter C here that's tilted. And then thinking about it over here, C. Music makes me feel like I did something. And then now that we have this C, we're just gonna connect this back into here with another C. So now it's almost an S. See that letter S? And if you've drawn with me before, you know that I talk a lot about the different kinds of lines that we use, which is C curves, a reverse C, S shapes, reverse S, and then straight lines. So those shapes show up all the time. If you think about an oval, it's just two long C's that are connected to each other. This is a C shape. C shape. Okay, now let's open up her bill. She's gonna have a nice big open smile. So I'm just gonna actually draw straight through the beak, even though this part of the beak, bill, is behind the front. Just gonna go all the way down to the bottom. And if you remember when we drew Donald, the bottom of his bill was kind of squared off like this. But for Daisy, I like rounding it out a little bit, just because that helps keep her a little bit different than Donald. A figment song. Turn that down. And then we're gonna go connect it up to the other side. It's been a while since we've been to Disney World. I'm excited to go back whenever we're able to go back to Florida. We've been still at home since the start of this, so I know that different places have opened up differently. But in California, it's actually been pretty much the same since March of 2020. So we're excited to get this vaccine finally. And not finally, I know it came by super fast, but we're ready to see your family and travel a bit. So now I'm just drawing the bottom lip. In doing that, I'm just following the same line that I had for the bottom part of the bill. Look, I called it a bill without having to correct myself. Now she has a little V right in the top of her mouth. That's her tongue. Just connect that V right in the vertical line that we drew here, right underneath the bottom of the bill. And I'm just gonna shade in the side of my pencil, this part of the mouth, just so we know that's inside. Now, I'm just going to, since we already have the top of her head, I wanna just kind of slightly darken in this area, show that the brows are in front of that. I'm darkening here, here. We're eventually gonna go over this with a black pencil, but I'm just leaving little notes for myself so that I know about the overlap. And if you don't know about overlap, it's a super useful tool as an artist to let your audience viewer know exactly what's in front of another thing. So you can see when I outlined this in the darker color, I'm saying that this circle is in front of this circle, but this circle is in front of this circle, and then both of these are in front of this one. So in order to give your audience a sense of depth, that's a good way to show overlap, and it's just which lines cross in front of the others. It'd be confusing if the back of the head we could see through the eyebrow. So we don't want to do that. Okay, so let's go ahead and start putting in the bow. I'm saving the eyes for last because that's when it really starts to look like Daisy. So similar to this oval, we're gonna put that up here. Minnie had a different shape here. Her bow is a little bit more plump and wide, but Daisy's bow is actually pretty tall. So I'm gonna draw a little oval here This is gonna be the center of the bow. Again, because of overlap, it's gonna be behind the forehead. So I'm going to make sure that that part is the darkest part. How are we doing so far? I bet you're doing great. Okay, so now we're going to draw the sides of the bow. So the bow's gonna come out and then back over towards the head. So if you just think about it, another stretched out C shape that goes out diagonally to the right. And then it starts curving back around. So now it's starting to look like a candy cane, right? C shape back. And then it curves back in. It's kind of a kooky shape, but if you just break it down like that, C shape, another C shape here, reverse C shape. It's a practice one. Let's do the left one now that we know what we're doing. So we're gonna go up this way, C shape, C shape, and back in, and then back around. Hi, Daisy. It's interesting, I don't know this about her. Her first cartoon that she was in was called Don Donald, but her name was Donna Duck, which is obviously not who she is. So that was in 1937. 3 years later, there was a cartoon called Mr. Duck Steps Out, and Donald goes on a date with her, dance around her house, and that's where she became Daisy. 1940. Okay, so now let's draw the inside of the bow. So in order to show that there's a little bit of depth and it's not just like a flat piece of paper stuck there, I'm gonna draw, not connected to here, just gonna be floating out here, just another C. It's almost a straight line, but you can see it's a little bit curved here. And then just to make it different so that they're not the same on both sides, I'm gonna draw a little rounded line that does connect. Okay, there's a couple more lines to do before we get to the eyes. I hope you stuck with it. Let's draw her. She has, if you were to see her from the side, she has sort of a, hopefully you can see this. These kind of these like cheeky hairs that come off to the back of her. And so what we're gonna do is just kind of draw that actually on both sides, and that helps give her a little bit more femininity than, like for Donald, he has just a, like a cheek bump and then a circle that comes up here. But for her, she just has these like feathery lines. And so the way that I do that, and you can just practice that over here, is just C shape, it's like a little rounded line. And in this, you can see that these are sort of equal apart, but when I put them here, they're closer. So try to keep the distance between the tops of these lines separate and different, so that like this one is farther away than these two, so that it makes it feel a little bit more organic and not so stiff. But if you're just learning how to do that now, then, you know, get used to the way that your hand moves first, and then you can worry about the distance. Okay, I think it's time. Let's go ahead and draw the eyeballs. She's gonna be looking right at us. So I want to draw another oval, similar to her eyeball oval. It's just gonna go right there. And it's connecting here. And this is actually, I've talked about this before, but this is super helpful to make your characters not look cross-eyed. See how the side of the eyeball goes down, and then you see what it's called, the iris or the pupil here. There's this little bit of space between those two. That helps the character look like they're looking forward, but still has that like Disney appeal where the eyes are almost crossed. So I'm just gonna draw that same thing over here. Because like, for me, and every artist is different, so. But I love when the eyes are sort of getting close to getting across, but not quite there. So, because she's happy, she's probably looking at Donald here. She's got a little sparkle in her eye. We're gonna draw a circle there, just to make sure that we remember not to color that in. That's just gonna be shine. So that's almost Daisy, it's pretty close. But if you know Daisy, she's got a little bit of attitude. So we're gonna draw her eyelids. So you'll notice when I drew the eyelid that the one closest to the center of the face is a little bit lower than the one that goes out to the side. That's why I wanted to draw it first so you could see it. So you can see one eye like that and one eye like this. That's where we're at right now. But we want them to be the same. So I'm gonna start over here. Bring it out. We're so close. I'll show you what's next. We have to draw her eyelashes. So she has three eyelashes on each side, and we'll go ahead and start with this one. So what I do is I'll pick the highest point of the eyelid and that line that we just drew, and then she's got really long eyelashes that go out. I'm just gonna draw out there, and it's sort of another curved C line that drifts up. There really are not any straight lines in Daisy's design. And I'm gonna draw another one. She has three of them. Right there. And then another off to here. And again, they're hairs, so they shouldn't be identical. Shouldn't be like, there should be a little bit of difference between them. So you can see that this one is a little more straight, then it starts getting more rounded, and then the most rounded. So I'm gonna try that again over here. Stuck. Okay, so this is our scratchy animation drawing. Now I'm going to go in with this black pencil, just a regular black pencil. You can go in with even a school pencil, a number two pencil, and we'll start darkening in the lines that we want to keep. And this is the part of the process where we get to sort of hide all these extra scratchy lines. So remember, I told you to remember that scratchy circle. Let's see if it goes away. So I start when I do these outlining. I start on the left side of the drawing because I'm right-handed and I have a tendency to push my hand against the paper and smudge a lot. So this helps kind of clear the way so that my right hand is not on this kind of dark line and it won't smudge. See, I'm still pretty scratchy with my cleanup line. It's mostly about trying to make sure that the lines that should be in front still look like they're in front. There's a whole department at Animation Studios called Cleanup. And Cleanup is the people that go after the animator has drawn the drawing, they go back and make it look beautiful. So the actual lines that you see on screen are from Cleanup artists, and they don't get enough credit for the work that they do because they're not tracing. They're making really specific artistic choices that can enhance the drawing. If you see some animation drawings and then look at the cleanup drawing, it's wild. Some animators, I worked on one thing once and an animator was drawing something and animated everything except for the face. It was a full body animation, but the face was still part of the performance, and they didn't draw a single drawing of the face. So they left it up to the cleanup artist to actually draw the face of the character, which is not typical. That's not how it should be. But anyway, all that to say, cleanup artists are brilliant. I am not one of those, but I'm learning how to get better at it. Oh, see, I'm about to smudge it. If you've drawn with me before, you know about this trick I'm about to use. When I get close to smudging, I just grab another sheet of paper and then put my hand on that instead of on the line, and then I can move my hand around all over the place. As long as I lock this paper down, it's not gonna be smudging anything. So for these eyelashes, since they're hairs, I'm gonna go a little bit thicker as they get closer to the eyeball. And then they get thinner when they get out there. I used to live in Florida. And when I lived there, I was a PhotoPass photographer at the Walt Disney World. I would always be at Hollywood Studios, which I still call MGM Studios because I grew up there. And a lot of times I would be paired up to take pictures of Daisy. And she is so much fun. Take pictures of the guests with, because she just has so much energy and people, I think they really connect with her. So it was always a good day whenever I got paired with Daisy. I want to wait to color in her eye, because that's a lot of smudgeable lines, and I don't want to do that. So I'm gonna sharpen this. It's gonna be loud. If you're wondering, we're still working from home, Disney Animation. We started working from home a year ago. I don't think any of us anywhere around the world thought that we would still be in the same place we were a year ago, but here we are. We know a lot better how to work from home now, so it feels like there'll be more options for people moving forward. So do the bottom. I have this cool animation desk that I can just spin around. You probably have a piece of paper on a table that you can also just spin around, but this is a professional way to do it. A lot of times, the reason why I spin it is because I want, if I can, to draw from an angle that pushes my pencil line away from my wrist so I can arc outwards. It's hard for me to do lines that arc inward. That's not true for everybody, so you might be better than I am. But as much as I can, I try to angle my paper so that I can arc away from my shoulder. So I'm just gonna go upside down. Disney just finished, Raya and the Last Dragon, was done almost entirely at home. It's animated for the most part at home. And the film I'm on, which they have since announced since we last were on, is called Encanto. And that film will probably be done at home as well. been there working on it for all this time. Can't wait till more of it's out so you can see it. I want to talk about it, but I can't. Pro tip, if you want to feel like you're doing something special and magical, you should just listen to music from Beauty and the Beast while you're drawing. I feel like I'm racing it. Last time Daisy was in a movie, I feel like it was probably Fantasia 2000. It's a great sequence, pomp and circumstance, the music that they're using, and it's like a Noah's Ark scene with her and Donald on the Ark. We're thinner when we get out to the end. There's a shading thing on her too that's specific to Daisy, and I think even outlived the style that it usually happened in like the 40s. I'll show you if we're done with this. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and darken the eyes. So again, we're gonna color everything in this circle that isn't in this circle. That's just gonna be a highlight. Once you color these eyes in, that's where it really comes to life. Okay, now let's do that little trick. So I'm gonna bring back the red pencil just so we can mark it off. So if we're going to color in her eyelids, they're going to be not totally colored in, and there's going to be a section that will still be kind of like a highlight. So in order to do that, I'm just going to draw some rounded lines here really, really lightly. This is just for me to have a reference for. I don't even know if you can see them in the video. And then now when I shade in with a darker pencil, I'm going to go lighter than I colored in the eyeball and then not color in the center part here. So I'm just going to color these outside triangles, the little pie wedges over here. In the 40s, they always had this kind of, almost looked like rubber, this texture to highlight things. And so I still feel like that looks like Daisy. I know we colored the inside of the mouth red, but I'm going to also go in and kind of shade it in a little bit like this. So it's going to be like a dark red. And her bow is normally like a purple pink kind of color, but that'll look weird in my drawing because of the pencil I use. So I'm just going to color it in with the same color that I did the underdrawing with. And I'm just doing a shadow here for where the bill overlaps the bottom bill. When I color things in, you'll see that I use the side of my pencil because you get a softer look than if I were to color it in like this. So I do a lot of that with this pencil. Thank you. music. It makes me feel like I'll work out. And draw and draw and draw and draw and left and right and draw and left and left and right and draw and draw and shade it. Just gonna shade it in a little bit here at the bottom, a little darker. Show off that overlap. Do the other one. So I hope you finish this drawing. I hope you give yourself a chance to learn. You don't want to stop yourself from learning the next thing. There's a great quote that I'm going to butcher from Glenn Keane, who's one of my favorite animators. Animated The Genie and Beast. Not The Genie, excuse me. He animated Aladdin and The Beast. And Tarzan and all sorts of Disney legends. And he said that every time he feels like he needs to learn something, it's exciting because at the end of it, he's gonna come out with more knowledge than he had when he came in. And you always want, as you're drawing, learning how to draw, you wanna kind of build your knowledge of how to draw certain things. So when it's hard, that's a good thing. That means that you're about to become a better artist. And maybe you thought that you couldn't, maybe you thought you were awesome and reach the pinnacle of art, but there's always more to learn. So it's exciting to figure out where that journey is going to go. And there she is. We're not done until we sign it. You know the rules. I like to sign mine down here at the bottom on the right, so I'm going to do that. But you sign your name wherever you like. Daisy, I'd love to see your drawings. Please, if you're going to post them online, use the hashtag drawingwithwoodsy so I can find them. You can also tag me at @AnnamWoodsy. I'm on Instagram and Twitter. I'd love to see and share your drawings with the world. Thank you for joining me. It's been fun to come back to this. Been busy at work, but it's a celebration, right? It's a year since we all met each other, so I'm excited to start up just for a week or so, and we'll see how it goes. So share your drawings. Remember, if you like this drawing, give it to somebody special. I'm sure somebody would like to have it. And remember, just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone. So thank you for spending your Monday with me. Bye now.